Children are welcome to participate in one video or watch all three and discuss it with their parents and their family. Next week, our Sunday school program for the 2021 season will draw to a close. That's May 16th at 6 o'clock. We will be having Faith and Fun by the Fire Pit in the Prayer Garden. That's 6 o'clock on the 16th. We'll have s'mores for fellowship. And COVID protocols will apply, music and a lesson as we wrap up the season and head into the summer. Our ongoing ministries, there's additional information. We encourage you, as always, to check the messenger for their, updates on those ministries and invitations to participate. Let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth.
Break forth into joyous song and sing praises.
Sing praises to the Lord with the lyre.
With the lyre and the sound of melody.
With trumpets and the sound of the horn.
Make a joyful noise before the King, the Lord. grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, you have prepared for those who love you joys beyond understanding. Pour into our hearts such love for you that, loving you above all things, we may obtain your promises, which exceed all we can desire. Through Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from 1 John. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ has been born of God. And everyone who loves the parent loves the child. By this we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we obey his commandments. And his commandments are not burdensome, for whatever is born of God conquers the world. And this is the victory that conquers the world, our faith. Who is it that conquers the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came by water and blood, Jesus Christ, not with the water only, but with the water and the blood. And the Spirit is the one that testifies, for the Spirit is the truth. The word of the Lord. The Holy Gospel according to John, the 15th chapter. Jesus said, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing, but I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you. And I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another." The Gospel of the Lord. Recorded and released as a non-album single, many believe that this song encapsulated the summer of love. Written by John Lennon in 1967, this song was first performed on the first ever globally televised link via satellite. It became, as Rolling Stones writer Gavin Edwards suggests, a tune that had gone around the world and belonged to everybody. Can you guess the name of the song? If you guessed "All You Need Is Love," you are correct. Lennon supposedly wrote the song on love because he felt love could be understood across all cultures and all languages. Ringo Starr wrote, "We were big enough to command an audience of that size. And it was for love. It was for love and bloody peace. Peace and love, people putting flowers in guns." However, I wonder, now as we look back on that time, some 54 years later, do we believe love is all we need? More than 100 years following the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus, and thousands of years before the Beatles were a twinkle in their mother's eye, The Johannine community to whom our first John author is writing is skeptical. They're struggling with doubt. However, their doubt is specifically about Jesus. If God is love, they argue, isn't love all we need? Why Jesus? It is as if they are asking, what does Jesus mean for us now as we enter the second century? Grappling with the real theological questions surrounding Jesus in the midst of the practical concerns of his community, our author identifies what his detractors have missed in their argument. There's a catch. Something evident to him that others in his community just cannot see. This catch is likely the source of their conflict and the concern of this author. This community does not love one another as they ought. Perhaps too we can become skeptical. Why Jesus? What does Jesus really mean for us now as we navigate the practical concerns of our 21st circumstances in this century? First John reminds us, we too do not love one another as we ought. Today in the U.S. we celebrate Mother's Day. For some it is a day of joy, and for others a time of mourning. For many holidays, such as these, engender a range of complex emotions as each navigate the complicated relationships of their lives. We have not all been loved as we ought. And we struggle to love ourselves and those entrusted in our care as we ought. Strive as we might in the roles that we inhabit in relationship with one another, whether it be mother, father, sibling, spouse, or neighbor, we fall short of the divine love that is God. Its consequences are vast. Consider that on the far side of Mother Earth right now, fellow children of God in India are dying at a rate of 125 deaths per hour as the coronavirus spirals out of control. No, we do not love as we ought. And so I ask again, do we believe love is all we need? The statement, God is love, could also be a summary of the First John epistle. However, it is only because in the mind of the author, that statement encapsulates an incarnate God in Jesus Christ. God is the one who came by water and blood in Jesus Christ so that we may learn to love one another as we ought. In and through water and blood, symbols of birth and rebirth, baptism and death, human and divine, God became enfleshed. The answer to Jesus is enshrined in the Nazarene's two natures. God, Jesus was both human and divine. Divine love was born from earthly mother in human form. That love Jesus bore witness to during his human life loves us in our very human limitations so that we may learn to love others in theirs. Jesus Christ calls us to love God in the human. Therefore, loving God is loving one another as Jesus loved us, with mercy, forgiveness, and self-sacrificing compassion. We need Jesus Christ, for only in and through Jesus may we conquer the evil forces of this world with love. Whether it be vanquishing the pain of our own brokenness, learning new ways of communicating love in complicated relationships, or springing into action when our siblings of God on the far side of the globe are suffering. With and through Jesus may we love as we ought, putting flowers into guns and proclaiming peace and love. For it is through the faith of Jesus Christ on the cross that divine love has already conquered, that we may also conquer with love. Is it easy, as our beautiful song suggests? When left to our own devices, all evidence points to the contrary. No. However, believing in and through the way of Jesus Christ, it is possible. In this we may trust, for as David Resenberger writes, all this love is one love, and love and belief intertwine inseparably around each other and work indivisibly within each other. Because divine love in Jesus believed in us, so may we. Therefore, perhaps we can answer our question, is all we need love? Yes. All we need is the divine love of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Loving God, you call us to be your fruit-bearing church. Strengthen the bonds among all Christian churches amid our differences, and guide us as your hands in this world. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Creating God, the earth praises you. The seas roar and the hills sing for joy. Fill the earth with your love so that by their song all creatures of land and sea and sky, burrowing and soaring, may call us to join with them in praise. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Faithful Savior, you conquer the world not with weapons but with undying love. Plant your word in the hearts of the nation's leaders and give them your spirit, so that the peoples of the world may live in peace. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Caring healer, you forget no one and accompany the lonely. Be present with those who are sick or suffering. Especially we pray for Nancy, Ruth, Robin, Dorothy, Robert, Gigi, Herbert, Marilyn, Stacy, George, and those we name aloud or silently at this time. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Gracious God, as a mother comforts her child, you comfort us. Bless mothers and mothering people in our lives. Comfort those who miss their mothers, mothers who grieve, those who grieve because they cannot be mothers, and those who have never known a loving mother. Especially we pray today for Mother India and our siblings there who are suffering from COVID-19. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray together boldly. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us take time to share the peace of Christ with one another at this time. At this time, we also offer with joy and thanksgiving what God has first given us, ourselves, our time, and our possessions, all signs of God's gracious love. All of those offerings are received through the church and through the lobby and in other ways. We give thanks to God. Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. Through your goodness, you have blessed us with these gifts, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Use us and what we have gathered in feeding the world with your love. Through the one who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Sound of the symphony to my ears.
Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen. Go in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your kingdom come.